Once known as Atomic Town, Qihai is where China's first atomic and hydrogen bombs were created in the 1960s. China was then under nuclear threat by some major world powers and had to increase its scientific and defense capabilities. Responding to the call, thousands of scientists and researchers came here and dedicated themselves to the two bombs and one satellite project. With an average altitude of 3,500 meters, the lowest temperature here is close to minus 30 degrees Celsius, making living conditions extremely harsh. During the same period, China also made technological breakthroughs in missile development and successfully launched its first conventional and nuclear missiles.
当时原子弹还有一个代号叫蒸汽弹。那个时候没有专业人员，他们就进行突击培训，以老带新，没有图纸，他们就自己动手绘制，自力更生，艰苦奋斗，正是两弹一星事业取得成功的立足基点。
Space scientist Guo Yonghui was a leading researcher of China's first satellite, Dongfenghong 1. Because of his work, he had little time to spend with his family. His daughter once asked for a birthday gift when she was little. Guo pointed to the sky and said, "In the future, there will be one more star in the sky. That will be a gift from Dad." On December 5th, 1968, Guo left the research facility in Qinghai for Beijing with a top-secret document. Unfortunately, his plane crashed, and he died at the age of 59。当人们在机身的残骸当中找到郭先生的时候，他和他的警卫员紧紧地抱在一起。他们用自己的身体保护了一个装有绝密文件的公文包。一年多以后，我们国家的第一颗人造地球卫星发射成功。
也许这就是郭先生许给他女儿的星星的礼物。两弹一星事业的背后，是成千上万科技工作人员、工程技术人员、后勤保障人员陆力通心，创造了世界科技史上的奇迹。大力协同、勇于登攀，是两弹一星事业取得成功的重要保证。希望广大科技工作者。 不忘初心，牢记使命，秉持国家利益和人民利益至上，继承和发扬老一辈科学家胸怀祖国、服务人民的优秀品质，弘扬两弹一星精神，主动肩负起历史重任，把自己的科学追求融入建设社会主义现代化国家的伟大事业中去。
两弹一星科技工作者，热爱祖国。 无私奉献、自力更生、艰苦奋斗、大力协同、勇于登攀的宝贵精神，是我们中华民族宝贵的精神财富。我们自当学习和发扬这一精神，做出我们自身应有的贡献。